Vale, vamos.
My name is Ben Huckey. I'm limping because I blew out my knee. I don't yet know what's wrong with it, so I don't get to go to the specialist till January. So until then, I guess I'm stuck with this leg brace. How fun is that? No bike.
Past, I know you tried to get a contest a bunch, and it just hasn't really worked out because of money and time limitations, and I was wondering if you're still trying to do that, or what's up with that?
I don't know, last year it's been kind of rough. I've been struggling, like, keeping on my bike every day, all day, and shooting pictures as much as I can, filming, just to please my sponsors so we can work together, please them, and I realize contests, like, not the most important aspect of bike riding, but I just want to be able to get out there and travel and, you know, get a ride with new people and hang out and, like, represent. And so hopefully, you know, in the near future, we can get together and this will all work out.
I don't really see myself as any one kind of rider. I pretty much like to ride everything. I really enjoy to ride at Summit skate parks a lot, and trails. I love riding dirt. It's like some of my favorite riding. Yeah, I think it's wild how big BMX is actually getting today. Seeing bike riders on cereal boxes, video games, and all sorts of stuff like that coming out. And you can look at it in a good way or a bad way. There's no reason to talk negative about it or anything like that. Some people might be stoked, some people might not. If you want to be a part of it, be a part of it. If not, just go about your own ways. I like having fun riding my bike. You'll pay for everything you've done. If you could not, I'd pay for what was I done.
Pretty much grew up riding Burnside, waking up at 6 in the morning, riding down there by yourself in the rain, towel in your backpack, sit there for an hour or two, dry your tires off, mess around. Grew up on steep cement tranny, riding street, that's pretty much all I really know, you know, and I don't know, it adapts you well, you can ride anything, I don't know. I'd much rather be at a cement park than some wooden ramps. Riding's a funny thing, dude. It's like one instant you're crushing and learning new tricks every day, and the next you're out, and like, that's pretty much what happened. It was a frame stand ice pick in front of my house, dude, and my shoulder just popped out and it went back in, and you think it's one of those things, you just ice it and it'll be good, and it just kept popping out, and it got worse and worse, and slowly you fall into the hole, and it's like falling into the abyss. It's like the worst possible thing you can ever imagine. You're like, you don't want to admit it, so you try and mentally force yourself to change that, and it wasn't working. I just kept getting like more into the hole, you know, and so went to the doctor, and yep, you know, I need surgery, it's all torn, everything, all the ligaments are falling off, blah, blah, so I'm just like, let's do it, you know. I get surgery in like January, and it was probably the worst thing. I mean, it's the worst and the best, I don't know. I mean, it was like 4.5, 5 months, I quit smoking cigarettes, I got on it. You really think, like, after an injury like that, everybody says, and it is true, like, I mean, it's the same old thing, you know, like, after that, you really think it what matters most to you, you know, and that's your health and riding with your friends, so it's just like, you get back on it tenfold over, you know, you do 180 degrees if that's what means the most to you in your life, dude, and that's what it took, so I still do exercises every day, and it's getting a lot better now. It's I can bunny hop again, and things are changing a lot, you know, and I'm finally getting back to where my body's 100%, and Things will be happening.
We woke up at 10:30 to get ready for the contest that's happening tomorrow. We made some prizes, then we headed over to Jones Soda in downtown Seattle and picked up some soda and some products from them. And hung out with Cass for a minute, and then we headed over to Woodinville to meet up with Mark Johnson at FSA, and he gave us a few products, some cranks and headsets and a whole bunch of stuff, actually.
Okay, don't let my boss see this.
And then we headed back to my house and took all my old race trophies and spray painted them pretty much bright pink and gold, and just built them into the ugliest things we could actually come up with, and wrote Element Appeal all over them and got them ready for the contest tomorrow. 10:30 came around and we headed down to the skate barn to get ready for the practice. We had about 80 or 90 people that signed up tonight, and we're going to put all that money back into the pro purse, so it's looking pretty good. We're hoping to double or triple the entry amount, or the amount of fuel for the entries tomorrow. gonna get a few hours of sleep and wake up tomorrow at 7 o'clock.
It's 7:52 and we're currently en route to the skate barn. Running red lights. Gotta get there by 8 o'clock, meet Ed the owner to mop the place. It's pretty slick right now, but we want to make sure it's running smooth for everybody so we have no complaints.
What's going on now, Josh?
Tell me.
I guess the cop will tell us.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
There's a couple jokes because your speed. You got a radar, 44.
I just watched you pull a red light on, or run a red light on film. Are you glad you're not getting busted for that?
I'd rather get busted for a red light than get busted for a 43 or 44 and a 30.
How do you think this is going to influence the schedule of the day?
I think I'm going to go mop in haste and go home and go to sleep.
Did you really think that it was over?
I think it was great. Like, there's all this great talent in the Northwest, and nobody's really had an opportunity to show off and to expose themselves and ride to their fullest and compete against some of the best riders in the country. So it was good for all the kids, especially like Andrew Carpenter and the Sunbaum brothers and those guys, just because they've never really got to enter a contest before, and there's just so much pent-up energy that needed to be let out, and I think it was great. I think things are going to start happening for everybody.
Parts of it, you just got to realize how much fun it is and keep that in the forefront.
My bike consists of parts from Hoffman Bikes and Primo Products and others from my garage. Handlebars are Hoffman jumping bars, and they're my favorite bars. I've been riding, I've had three pairs within the past 6 years, I guess, so they're the only bars I'll ever ride. My forks are Hoffman dirt jumping forks. I got the dropouts cut out to 14 millimeter just for doing street stuff and just to, you know, keep my axle from bending and everything. My rear wheel is a Hoffman high roller. It's a high roller hub, 48 spoke. It's a really good wheel, light, and holds up very well. My cranks are Primo Power Bite cranks. They're 175 millimeter. It seems to, help do bar spins and stuff because my feet are closer together. Has the new steel inserts. They're just really good cranks because they don't come loose hardly at all. They seem to last a long time. My frame is Hoffman Rhythm. It's kind of a trails frame, but it's a very light frame, and I've been riding it for about 2 months, and it's really good for street and pretty sure trails as well. As you can see, there's what you've noticed already. I have no brakes on my bike, so I cut the 990 mounts off and everything else just to take off some weight. My paint came from Walmart. Krylon flat black and gray. I just like to be a little creative, and as well as my stickers are actually paint too because they last longer. That's my bike.
Yeah! The way you fear for your life, I don't remember the place I was when the president died. But I recall the fall of nuclear rain and burst skies. Lucky that I was underneath ground, hidden beneath the beat down. Freaked out, listening for some street sound. The subway shook and stopped, I got knocked out. Woke up hours later when I heard a wounded cop shout. You okay? Yeah. Just hold tight. He disappeared into the dust, I never saw him again. The tunnel was caving in, I made my way fumbling through the dark. Tripping over debris and body parts. Can't start panicking, ran up in the toll booth. Tried to call for help, but then I learned the cold truth. The phone was dead and so was the attendant. But her radio was on and it said New York was gone.
Whoa, Nelly, sorry about the turbulence. If you're just tuning in, you're listening to Radio Free Brooklyn. That big bump you felt was what we in the industry call a nuclear attack. Looks like Manhattan, as well as the southern portion of the Bronx, is gone. Brooklyn sustained considerable damage, kids. It's safe to say that schools are closed. Stay tuned to Radio Free Brooklyn for more information.
Before my eyes, I see birthdays and the murder rate sky high, multiplied by aggression. Then I thought I took my last breath when the earth moved. My spirit had been collided with virtues and amendments. Should I drop to my knees, Lord, and repent? Or was I sent to spread the word through these vents we call radio free? Brooklyn, why you at it? Forced to kick habits. Sorry if I'm being too dramatic. Would this be the time to practice black magic? Or do I need to rest my head on a craftmatic? Think of ways to free my people from political bondage. Political nonsense, I'm sick of arguing about our problems. Now I'm dodging anthrax and suicide bombers instead of walking the steps of my forefathers. Nothing makes sound. Strange the way these airplanes went down. Millisecond flashback back to the military combat cemetery now with the black clouds covering and hovering about. My body's half out, struggling, using my arms, fumbling. Nuclear a bomb crumbling due to this harsh government. Fist clenched, six cents, something within distance. Six inch, penetrate my nostrils, I'll pinch them with one hand. Didn't make a difference, I'm done, man. 90% of my body burnt without a suntan. Falling forward towards something mortable, possible portable audio. Maybe earphones get close to take it off the head, there's no cutting. Only sound I got in Radio Free Brooklyn.
Hello, my name is Ben Ward, and I'm here to teach you this month's trick tip for Z-Ride. This month, we're going to teach you how to do crank flips. Let's see, we'll start with the scooping with the front foot. You find a good obstacle. Pyramid hips are good. You can try bunny hopping if you want. You can try rolling across the ground. What you do is you get going. Say you're going over a pyramid hip, and you bunny hop like you're jumping the hip, and you start to do a back pedal. Once your cranks are up and down, you remove your back foot and keep scooping it with your front foot and tossing the cranks around. You stick your front foot out there to catch the pedal and stick your other foot on it right away. And that's how you basically do a crank flip with your front foot. The other way you can do a kick flip is by just kicking it with your back foot like you're kick-starting a motorcycle. Go off a jump, hip, whatever you want to use. And you go in the air, kind of go no-footer, and just kick down with your back foot. Let the cranks come around, catch them, and land. It's pretty simple. And that's how you do a backflip kickflip. Holla. Stray Cats.
Hi, this is Ben Ward, and that's how you do a crank flip. And this is really lame.
I got the love. Hi, my name is Andy Phillips, and
I'm John Wood,
and we're Little Brother Revenge.
Last winter, Andy was in a electric band that he wasn't too pleased with, so he started messing around with acoustics, and people seemed to like it and take to it, so we decided to record a demo and try to play shows and stuff, and people have really taken to it, so we've gone into full time with it and took it as something very serious, and which started out as something that was just a side project, a little mess around thing, turned into what we hope to be a career.
What influences us, what motivates us, basically like wanting to do something on our own and have something, you know, we could put our stamp on, and like seeing other people do it and being inspired by like a lot of, you know, the bands out there, and our family's been really helpful and really supportive of us, and just wanting to you know, go out there and, you know, do our own thing and kind of hang it out on the line and see what happens.
What I have to say for me personally to influence to play music is just growing up and going to shows and just and seeing the interaction with like the performers and the crowd, and just seeing how, you know, and just personally how I'd go to shows and I'd just get a lot out of bands, you know, and I'd take it home, and you know, and for different emotions and feelings I've had, I've, you know, put in certain CDs, and like I've an inspiration to be in music for me and for us together, so that we can kind of in a sense return the favor, go full circle. But just mostly just because we want to, you know, try to touch people's lives as well. It might sound cheesy and stuff, but I mean, that's what happens a lot in music, just because people pour themselves into their songs, and it, you know, touches people in certain ways. So my main reason why I'd like to be in it is just because, just, you know, how much like passion like I've seen people have, you know, and I want to, you know, display that as well.
Well, how we got started and where we got started playing at was we just started by going to coffee shops, just finding out local coffee shops and just things, just so we can practice playing for people. We just found ones that did live acoustic shows and just live shows, and we gave them demos and stuff like that, and then eventually one of them asked us back, and we went there, and we flyered it and told everyone we know, and then just played there, and it kind of grew from that, just giving coffee shops and little places like that our demos, and then people heard it and liked it, so then they got us bigger shows at better places.
I liked, you know, to, for up and coming kids who are playing guitar and writing songs, and to just not be afraid to just to write whatever you feel, because you shouldn't. Some people try to write songs to appeal to people, or to write songs a certain way so people will like them, you know, and say, oh, I gotta write it because if it's not this way, then no one will like it. It's just kind of like, you gotta write songs for you, and, you know, to get out what you feel, and not to please anyone or to fit into a certain category or standard. And don't rate your music or yourself to other people, because that's just unhealthy and unwise, and you need to rate yourself according to yourself and not how, what other people are doing and where other people your age are at or all that kind of stuff.
Hi, my name is Bruce Christman. I'm here with this month's Z-Ride profile, and I'm going to take you around to where I grew up. Alright, I'm going to, drive around a little bit in my hometown of Tigard, where I grew up. started bike riding, started everything. And I don't know, let's take you to a few spots maybe to where I maybe first started learning tricks or whatever. I'm just gonna play it by ear really and see what happens.
Grew up here in Tigard, Oregon. It's a suburb right out of Portland. And I'm 23 years old at the moment. And pretty much been around here my whole life. Moved in and out a couple times, but for the most part lived here over 20 years. And as you can tell right now, it's, if you can see outside, it's raining, which it does a whole lot here in Portland. But I don't know, I'm accustomed to it by now. Plus, you know, like when the nice days during the summer come around, it just makes you appreciate it that much more for the riding days. Just have that much better time. I'm gonna take a right in here because I want to show you this rail since we're just passing by it. This rail is giving me a lot of problems for the last years. I've never tried it, but I'm just gonna let everyone see the rail that I'm scared to do. Let's go look at this thing. We're rolling right next to it. This thing's big to me. To me, it's big. Maybe not for some people, but to me. Alright, just look at the size of this thing. It's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, 14, 15 stair rail for some people isn't that big, you know, but this thing is this, I don't know, this is different. It's steep and gnarly and has this gnarly kink off the end. And I don't know, when you get up top, it's just a whole different story. You look at it from bottom, it's like, oh yeah, it'd be easy to. I know I could totally hop on this thing, but I'm just scared, just blowing up right when I hit the bottom. I don't know, it's no big deal, I just thought I'd show you that. It's one of the things that have been eating me up for the last 4 or 5 years. Maybe one of these days I'll get some guts.
Hi, how you doing?
Pretty good.
How much is gas today?
To
a lot of money, right?
Yeah.
How much is that a gallon?
$1.99
a gallon. $1.99 a gallon. That's why I'm gonna put $10 credit in, please.
No,
I can only afford $10 at a time. So it's really expensive up here. Thank you very much. $1.99 a gallon. The cheapest gasoline possible. That's why I ride everywhere. That's why I still ride a bike. People ask me, when am I going to grow up? And I just tell them, well, when I can afford to drive.
Wrong turn?